In the most recent version of Brackets, its 1.0 release, the ability to create your own keyboard shortcuts was added. I'll be demonstrating how to set up your own custom shortcuts in this video. To access your custom key bindings, you need to go to the debug menu and choose Open User Key Map. There are a few limitations on the shortcuts you can set up, so it does help to read the documentation that's referenced right here. What you want to pay attention to is this exceptions area telling you commands and shortcuts that cannot be overwritten. You'll need to add your overrides to the override section in the JSON format. That means you'll provide the keys in quotes, then a colon, then the command also in quotes. Each override needs to be separated by a comma. You'll want to type the keys with these key names shown in the table. Since this is a new feature, I'm still figuring out how I want to use this for my own workflow. I do know I would like to come up with some replacement shortcuts for those that are drastically different on Mac and Windows. Since I work on both platforms, that does cause me some confusion at times, but I haven't come up with my solution yet. One thing I do want to do, however, is swap File Open with Quick Open. I almost never use the standard File Open command with brackets, and I'm using Quick Open all the time since I'm always working on files within a project. I'd rather have the easier shortcut for Quick Open, Command plus O. Then I can use Command Shift O for regular File Open. So I'll type Command-O in quotes, then a colon. Next, I need to figure out what the command is. There's a link to the command.js file, which is a good place to look for most of the command names. I'll look for quick, and I can see that I need navigate.quickopen. You might notice that the command is the menu name, navigate, then the command, quickopen, which is one word in camel case. If you look at the rest of the commands, you can see that that's how they're organized. Knowing this can sometimes let you skip the step of looking things up. To add the next shortcut, I can add a comma since I want to add another override, and I'll type Command-Shift-O colon file.open. Based on what I know about the command names, this should work. Then I'll save it. The key bindings are written with dashes in between the keys. I sometimes want to type a plus, and if I do that, I'll get an error. Now if I try the new shortcuts, Command Shift O takes me to regular file open, and Command O takes me to quick open. Now I just need to get my fingers used to the new shortcuts. The menus don't always reflect the new shortcuts right away. It's showing Command O for quick open, but not Command Shift O for open. So we can refresh with Command R on a Mac or F5 on Windows. And the new key bindings will show on the menu now. Another shortcut I want to change is the project switcher. It's Command plus Alt plus R, and I use that one a lot, but it's not easy to type. I wanted to use Command or Control plus R because that works on Windows, but it's already taken for refresh here on the Mac. So I'm going to pick F4 instead. But when I look in the commands.js file, I don't find it. It isn't part of a menu, so it's not exposed here. There is a display shortcuts extension that I can use that will help me with this, however. I'll go to the extension manager and I just need to search for shortcuts. I'll install this now. If we go to the Help menu, we can see that there's a menu entry for it, but there's a shortcut for it also, Control plus Alt plus slash. It's the same on both platforms. It's giving a full listing of every keyboard shortcut. It will show all shortcuts from vanilla brackets and also shortcuts from any extensions that you add. I could scroll and try to find the shortcut I'm looking to change, but I could also try the filter. Since I want to update the shortcut for switching projects, I'll look for project. So I'll type recentprojects.toggle and save. Now I can get to recent projects more easily with F4. The keyboard shortcut for this display shortcuts toggle is Control plus Alt plus forward slash. I remember it as a question mark actually, since it's a help type shortcut. You can change shortcuts for extensions also, so I'm going to change this shortcut to something shorter. Command I is available, so I'll use that and think of it as info. If I search for a forward slash, it doesn't work, so I'll look for the word shortcut. I can see the command right here. That's a long name, so I'd like to be able to copy it, but I can't. Instead, I'll just move my cursor to the end of the file and hit this Copy to Current Document button. Then I can copy the name, undo my last command to get rid of that table, then paste it in when I type the key bindings. I saved it before putting quotes around the command, so I just need to fix that. It's giving me this error, but if I save it again, it will work. I think the previous error messed things up. And it isn't working yet, so I'll try refresh. And now it works, and I can toggle the shortcut display with Command plus I. If you ever decide you want to go back to the default shortcut, just delete the line and the old shortcut will be reverted to immediately when you save. So it's pretty simple to customize the shortcuts, especially if you add this Display Shortcuts extension, which will help you find the command name easily. Now that I've added my first extension to Brackets, I'm ready to show you some of my other favorite extensions. I'll do that in the next lesson.